right, we're going to get started. So wherever you are, in your living room, in your kitchen, maybe you're outside watching this, let's do our pledges. Here we go, Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for our Christian flag. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty for all who believe. And to our Bible. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. Awesome job. We're going to do our verse for this month, and it is 1 Peter 3, 8 through 11. Finally, all of you should be of one mind, sympathize with each other, love each other as brothers and sisters, be tender-hearted, and keep a humble attitude. Don't repay evil for evil. Don't retaliate with insults when people insult you. Instead, pay them back with a blessing. That is what God has called you to do, and He will grant you His blessing. All right, here are our three songs for this week. These are the last three songs that I know, so this is what we're doing. We'll get started with Your Love is Lifting Me.
Hallelujah. Your love is lifting me. 'cause it's happy time. Boom, shakalaka, laka, boom. Put your hands up high, now you bring them down low. Take them back up, now that's how we roll. Jump around, jump around. Now we're taking deep down to the house. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart, I love you, Jesus. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart. Do you love your Jesus? Deep down in your heart.
Yes, I love my Jesus. Deep down in my heart.
Do you love your Jesus? Deep down in your heart. Up high, now you bring them down low. Take them back up, now that's how we roll. Jump around, jump around. Now we're taking deep down to the house. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart, I love you, Jesus. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart. Well, do you love your Jesus? Deep down in your heart. Jesus, deep down in your heart, yeah.
Yes, I love my Jesus, deep down in my heart.
Put your hands up high, now you bring them down low. Take them back up, now that's how we roll. Jump around, jump around. Now we're taking deep down to the house. I said, deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart, I love you, Jesus. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart, sing it again. Deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart, I love you, Jesus. Deep, deep, all deep down, down. Deep down in my heart. Now put your hands up high, now you bring them down low. Take them back up, now that's how we roll. Jump around, jump around. Now we're taking deep down to the house. Put your hands up high, now you bring them down low. Take them back up, now that's how we roll. Jump around, jump around. Now we're taking deep down to the house. To deep down to the house. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, boy.
Come on. About to do it like this, about to do it like this, y'all.
One, two, three, four.
When I sit back and imagine life without you, I can't fathom how I ever thought I'd make it on my own. And there's at least a million reasons I'm still standing here believing. You're my comfort, you're my healing. This I know.
When you can't see the wind, but it moves the leaves from the bottom to the top of the tallest trees. You are everything that I'll ever need, and I can't take that from me.
Life without you, I can't fathom how I ever thought I'd make it on my own. And there's at least a million reasons I'm still standing here believing. You're my comfort, you're my healing. This I know.
You can't see the wind, but it moves the leaves from the bottom to the top of the tallest trees. You are everything that I'll ever need, and I can't take that from me.
Hello, CHA students. I hope you all are doing well and staying safe and all that good stuff. At the beginning, we forgot to mention our service project for this week, so I'm going to tell you it right now. Our service project is to pray for others. So send an email to your grandma or your grandpa or your aunt or uncle or even your parents and ask them how you can pray for them. All right, today we're going to be talking about how each and every one of us are created in the image of God. And before I begin, I want to start off by showing you a short little video explaining how God created everything. So, take a look.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was empty, formless, and dark. But the Spirit of God was there. On the first day, God said, "Let there be light." And God saw that the light was good. Then he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day and the darkness night. On the second day, God said, "Let there be a space to separate the waters of the heavens from the waters of the earth." God called the space sky. On the third day, God said, "Let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place, so dry ground may appear." God called the dry ground land, and the waters seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the land sprout with every sort of plant and tree." And God saw that it was good. On the fourth day, God said, "Let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night." God made two great lights, the sun for the day and the moon for the night. He also made the stars. God set these lights in the sky to light the earth, and God saw that it was good. On the fifth day, God said, "Let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind." And God saw that it was good. On the sixth day, God said, "Let the earth make every sort of animal." God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock, and small animals, each able to have babies of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, to be like us." So God created man in his own image. He formed man from the dust of the ground. He breathed the breath of life into man, and a man became alive. Then he saw that the man needed a helper, so God put man into a deep sleep, and while he slept, God took one of the man's ribs. Then God made a woman from the rib and brought her to the man.
Hello.
Hi.
Then God blessed them and said, "Be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and rule over it. Rule over the fish in the sea."
Hello, Will.
"The birds in the sky."
Hello, bird.
"And all the animals that scurry along the ground." Then God said, "Look, I have given you every plant throughout the earth and all the fruit trees for your food. And I have given you every green plant as food for all the animals." Then God looked over all he had made, and he saw that it was very good. So the creation of the heavens and the earth and everything in them was done. So on the seventh day, God rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and said it was holy.
Wow. Did you hear that last part? That all that careful planning and creating, all the trees and flowers and mountains and oceans, God did all that to create a perfect home for us. Can you believe it? And today, we're going to focus on how God created us and how we're the most special creation. It's pretty awesome. After God had made the whole world, he made people. He made us last, and he made us special. The Bible says God took the dust of the ground and he breathed life into it. Out of the dust came the first living person, Adam. Well, Adam did love living with God in his perfect home, a place called the Garden of Eden. He walked and talked with God, just like you and I can walk and talk with our friends. But God wanted Adam to have a helper, another friend in the garden. So he made Eve. But he didn't make Eve out of dust. He did something a little different. The Bible says God caused Adam to fall into a deep sleep. Then took out one of his ribs. If you feel the bones right above your belly, those are your ribs. God took one of Adam's ribs out and closed him back up. From that bone, God made Eve. Pretty cool, right? The coolest part is God made both Adam and Eve, just like he made both you and me in his own image. In Genesis 1:27, the Bible says this, "So God created man in his own likeness. He created him in the likeness of God. He created them as male and female." As you can see on the screen, I have just about every single Lego Avenger that I borrowed from my younger brother, who's probably not going to watch this, so he'll never have to know. So anyways, I have each and every Avengers in Lego form. So, what's unique about the Avengers is that each and every one of them has a different superpower. Iron Man, right here, he has an iron suit. You see Captain America has a shield, Thor has a hammer, and Hulk, he has super strength. They're all different. Now, what do you think happens if we take Iron Man, right here, and Iron Man tries to be Spider-Man? It's not going to work, because Iron Man does not have the same spider powers as Spider-Man does, and Spider-Man does not have the same kind of iron suit that Iron Man has. So, there wouldn't work. Now, it's important to understand this because God created each and every one of us different. For another example, as many of you know, Mrs. Easling will not be here next year. And so if I tried to teach music and creative arts like Mrs. Easling, guess what? It wouldn't work. Why? Because God gave us each individual and unique skill sets that are set for her and that are set for me. Does that make sense? It's the same with the Avengers. If they try to be who they're not, they're never going to defeat the evil villains. They all need to be different and unique in their special powers. Does that make sense? Cool. Let's tie this all together. Each and every one of us, boys and girls, are made in the image of God. We are his most special creation. The best part about being made in the image of God is that God wants to be close to us. He wants to walk with us, and he wants to talk with us, just like he walked and talked with Adam and Eve. Nothing else in God's creation is made in his image, just people. Now, if all of us people were all the same, this world would be such a boring place. That is why God created each and every one of us unique and different. So I want to encourage you to be yourself. And sometimes that's easier said than done, because we can sometimes get made fun of for being a little different. But being different is good. There's nothing wrong with being different. So take that encouragement and plant that in your heart. All right, that is our chapel message for today. Created in the image of God, let's close our eyes, bow our heads, and let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for creating each and every one of us unique in our own way. You created males from the sand, you created females from ribs. God, that is so cool. It's so cool how you breathe the breath of life into each and every one of us as you knit each and every one of us in our mother's womb. God, I pray that we embrace our differences, that we accept that no two people are the same. Not even twins are the same, God. And just thank you for creating this world and everything that's in it, God. I pray for those who may be sick and who are afraid of what's going on in the world right now, God. I just ask that you be with those people, that you heal them, and that you are with them, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, CHA, for watching, and we will see you later.